Yeah, dear student, today we continue with our chapter 12, that is consumer protection. And in the previous class, I taught you about the different type of legal protection available to the consumer provided by the Indian government. Near about 10 laws I told you about it, along with the consumer protection. Okay? So, no law in the country is effective unless the consumer is aware, clear, and ready to fulfill his responsibilities. So this is the major issue, because as I am continuously telling you, everything can't be codified. Har cheez ke liye kanoon nahi banaya ja sakta, aur bana bhi dena, then who is going to monitor that? Clear? So it is very necessary that consumers should be aware about their duties, clear, and responsibilities. So what are those responsibilities which you are supposed to be observed by us in order to stop the businessman to do the unfair trade or restrictive trade practices? So consumers should keep in mind several type of things in their mind while buying any of the things. So what are consumer responsibilities? So first is, be aware about several types of goods and services available in the market. Don't rely on a single product. And nowadays, the internet is the biggest tool. You are having review of each and every product. How product is working, which dealer is good, which salesman is good. Every information is available on internet. So be aware about the various types of goods and services available in the market, and don't rely on a single product or services. Second, buy only standardized goods. Buy only standardized goods. Clear? Carrying the sufficient mark. Yesterday in the 10th law I told you about BIS, Bureau of Indian Standard. We are issuing their standards. Clear? So for electronic or electric goods, the mark is ISI. Clear? So buy only standardized goods and look for the signs which provide quality assurance. Clear? If ISI mark is there, this means the product is following, electrical equipment is following certain standard, and it will not give you shock. Clear? FBO mark on food items, on grains, the egg mark sign will be there. Clear? So different types of standards have been provided by the government. Clear? Third, learn about the risk associated with the product. Risk associated with the product. Learn about that. For example, you are using electric iron, it is shock proof, but still it can be kept away with the water. Otherwise, it will give you a shock. Clear? On your two-wheeler, it is written, do not accelerate while braking. So, don't show the stunts. Stunts are done by the professional with the professional bike. Don't do this on your domestic bike. It's not good. It is going to spoil your product and its life. Clear? Next, read labels carefully. Read labels carefully so that you may have full information about the product, manufactured, contents, use, ingredients use, the way of the use, if it is medicine, doses, side effect, everything. So only your curiosity will help you in avoiding the problems. Clear? And be honest in your dealings. Be honest in your dealings. Now what does it mean? Always insist on a slip or a bill. Pay proper tax to the government in order to have a fair deal. If you go for adopt any type of these practices, this is going to spoil your product or may lead you into the trouble. You may get a substandardized good or something else. Clear? So be honest. Always insist on a bill or cash memo, several types of voucher I taught you. Clear? The moment you feel any problem, always complain about that product. First complain to the respective customer care center, write an email to the concerned email given at the back of the product. So try to follow everything like that. Clear? And if company is not able to listen to you, file a complaint in appropriate consumer forum. Clear? See, several type of product, for example, ISI is there, FBO is for food products, clear? Agmark is for grain. So these are the fine. Clear? Now we will see the redressal agencies or redressal mechanism. Okay, now we will see the redressal mechanism
under the Consumer Protection Act, means where you are going to complain. Clear?
So government has set up three-tier machinery. Clear? Three-tier means three-level redressal mechanism. Redressal means आपका जो दुख है आप उसको कहां पर रिपोर्ट करेंगे. So that thing is set up by the government. So government has set up three-tier or three-level. First is district forum, means at district level you can file a complaint, separate court is there. Then is state forum, that will be in the state capital. These two are maintained by state government. And third, if you are not satisfied with both of these, you can go to the national commission. This is maintained by central government. National Commission is regulated or controlled by the central government. Okay? So this is the redressal mechanism set up under this Consumer Protection Act. But before understanding this, we will see that who is a consumer under Consumer Protection Act. Who is a consumer under the Consumer Protection Act? Okay? So see the first line. Any person who buys a goods, clear? Any person, कोई भी व्यक्ति जो एक सामान को खरीदता है for a consideration, clear? For a consideration. Now what is consideration? Consideration means how you are making the payment. Clear? Means partly paid or promised or fully paid or promised or under any scheme of deferred payment. Deferred means delayed. For example, you have financed the vehicle, still you are a consumer. Even if you have paid a single installment, but you are a consumer. And any person who has paid the full amount, is still that person is a consumer. So both the person are consumer under this act. But always remember that this purchasing is useful for the personal use and is not for commercial or for resale. Clear? So this is the definition. Any person I am telling who buys a goods for a consideration, partly paid or promised or fully paid or promised, means aapne vaada kiya future mein, or under any scheme of deferred payment. Deferred payment is means if you have financed anything. Clear? Like no cost EMI, still you are a consumer. And any person who pays the full amount, that person is also a consumer. Second, any person, clear? Again, any person who hires or avail any service. See, both things are included in it, goods and service. So any person who hires or avails of any service for a consideration. Consideration means how you are going to make the payment. Clear? For a consideration which has been paid or promised. Ya to aapne pay kar diya ya promise kara hai. Or partly paid or promised. Or aapne partly mane kuch amount mein paid. Or under any scheme of deferred payment. Ya aapne jaise car hai. Car you have bought for full finance. 8 lakh ki car hai, full finance you have paid. Still you are a consumer. And such services are availed with the approval of the service provider, and but does not include a person able to for any commercial purpose. The basic purpose is that you are using goods or services for personal use and not for commercial. If you are making a use for commercial, then you are not a consumer.
clear? So this is the definition of consumer. Now the question arises, who can file a complaint? Clear? Who can file a complaint? Who can file a complaint? So again, any person versus any consumer. Any consumer, any registered consumer association. Any registered consumer association, it's a group of person. Clear? Next is central government or state government. Clear? One or more consumers on behalf of several consumers. For example, if any chit fund company has cheated several person, one or two or five can also file a case. That is also equivalent. Clear? A legal heir or representative of a deceased person. Legal heir means वारिस. कोई person है, वो किसी की गलती से dead हो गया, तो उसके जो वारिस हैं, जो बच्चे हैं, या legal representative हैं, they can also file a complaint. Clear? Now, so this is the definition of consumer and complaint. Who can file a complaint? Now we will study this three-tier redressal mechanism under the Consumer Protection Act. Now we see the redressal mechanism under the Consumer Protection Act. So first is district forum. It is settled in every district of the country to settle the complaints arises from the deficiency in goods or services. So see the composition. Okay. It consists of one president. Clear? It consists of one president and two members. First member and second member, and one of whom shall be woman. Because there are several problems related to the house affairs or related to particular female personality, so for that purpose this system is set in. And the limit set for the district forum is ₹20 lakh. Clear? This is called pecuniary limit. Pecuniary means monetary limit. So pecuniary limit set up for district forum is up to 20 lakh you can file a case. Then comes the state forum or state commission. Again, state forum consists of one president and two member, first member and second member, and one shall be, one is woman. Clear? And pecuniary second limit is above 20 lakh but lesser than ₹1 crore. Clear? So this is the composition of state forum. These two are controlled by the state government. Now comes the national commission. So national commission consists of again one president and four member. First member, second member, third member and fourth member. Now why the number of member has been increased over here? Because the cases are reaching from whole country. Clear? Cases are reaching from the whole of the country. So it is very necessary to increase the number of members. And one is woman again. Clear? So this is the composition of national commission, and the pecuniary limit set up is more than ₹1 crore. So this is the redressal mechanism settled by NIM. And even if we are not satisfied with the order of national commission, we can go to the Supreme Court also. Clear? So only those appeals which are beyond ₹1 crore can go to the Supreme Court. Otherwise, the decision of these three agencies will be final. Why? ऐसा क्यों है? Otherwise, there shall be an end to litigation. End to litigation means case खत्म होना चाहिए. Otherwise, it will keep on lingering. क्लियर? आगे वो तो चलता ही रहेगा. और जो agree person है, that person is not going to get a release. In order to give a pause to the litigation, this thing is very necessary. क्लियर? So if the consumer court is satisfied with the genuineness of the problem, then consumer court will issue certain guidelines or a decision and pass such order which is going to give relief to the aggrieved person. Clear? So it may issue one or more of the following remedies for that person. Clear? So what is that? First is to remove the defect in goods. To remove the defect in goods. If there is a minor repair available at servicing, after doing that, if goods is going to be removed, then to remove the defect in the goods. Second is to replace the defective items. Replace means exchange, to replace that item, defective item, and to give a new one to the agreed person. Third, if the person is so much angry, he doesn't want the replacement, then to refund the price. Then to refund the price of the product. That is also one of the remedy, because sometimes person gets so much angry that he doesn't want to use the goods at all. So this thing can also be done. Clear? Fourth, to pay a reasonable amount of compensation. To pay a reasonable amount of compensation. To the agreed person, that is also one of the remedy. For any loss or injury suffered by the consumer due to the negligence of the opposite party. Even after the paying the money, if you have to suffer something, then you can get some amount as a compensation. Okay? To pay punitive damages. To pay punitive damages to the aggrieved person. To give a warning to that businessman to not to continue the unfair trade practices, that is called UTP or RTP, restrictive trade practices. Clear? Not to do anything, to give a warning to the concerned person to discontinue. Clear? Not to offer hazardous goods for sale. Not to offer hazardous goods for sale to the common public or person. It shall be given to the registered user with the proper licenses and permissions. Otherwise, it is not available locally. If sometimes goods are available for sale, then to withdraw the sale. To withdraw the sale of hazardous goods. Proper warning shall be given by carrying the chemicals and explosive item. That is why you will see the tankers carrying chemical. They will keep a distance of 10 to 20 feet. That if sometimes leakage happens, truck may get turtled. That in case you are not going to affect with that particular chemical. Okay? Then to seize the manufacturer of that hazardous goods. To seize the manufacturing process of that hazardous goods. Because of the rules and regulation, it's not good to produce that hazardous goods. To make further compensation for the mental harassment. Sometimes what is happening, a person may get affected or influenced by the defective advertisement or misleading advertisement, then to correct that advertisement and to pay the adequate cost to the appropriate party. Clear? So in this way, government has provided several relief to the agreed person. I hope this thing is clear to you. For any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you.